Hostel. Beneath the glittering facade of European travel, Paxton, Josh, and Ollie, three American backpackers, embark on a hedonistic odyssey, chasing adrenaline and cheap thrills. Drawn by whispered rumors of a Slovakian hostel brimming with beautiful women, they stumble upon a truth far more horrifying than a one-night stand gone wrong. Director Eli Roth artfully crafts a film that blends the raw terror of a slasher with the unsettling realism of a modern travel nightmare. The claustrophobic confines of the hostel become a breeding ground for paranoia and dread. Roth expertly manipulates the audience's expectations, drawing them into the protagonist's carefree adventure, only to shatter their sense of security with brutal efficiency. The performances are raw and nuanced, particularly Jay Hernandez as Paxton, whose initial bravado crumbles under the relentless onslaught of horror. The gradual descent into despair, the desperate struggles for survival, and the moments of chilling resignation are captured with unflinching honesty. As the true nature of the hostel unfolds, the film transcends mere violence, exploring the depths of human depravity and the chilling anonymity of the dark tourism industry. Wealthy individuals, seeking to enact their darkest fantasies, become the unseen architects of the horror, fueling a macabre market where human life is a commodity. Hostel is a gut-wrenching exploration of human vulnerability, the corrosive power of unchecked desire, and the insidious darkness that can lurk beneath the surface of seemingly ordinary lives. Roth navigates the genre's boundaries, pushing the limits of on-screen violence while remaining emotionally resonant and intellectually stimulating. The film's pacing builds tension through subtle cues and everyday anxieties before exploding into moments of shocking brutality. The horror is not solely visceral, but also psychological, tapping into our primal fears of isolation, betrayal, and the terrifying realization that we can become mere objects in someone else's twisted game. Hostel is not for the faint of heart. The film's graphic violence, disturbing subject matter, and unflinching portrayal of human cruelty can be deeply unsettling for some viewers. But for those of us who appreciate a well-crafted horror film that challenges expectations and sparks critical reflection, Hostel is a gem in the genre. The film's strength lies in its ability to confront our darkest fears and challenge our perceptions of morality. It reminds us that the monsters we most fear are not always lurking in the shadows, but can sometimes dwell within the hearts of those who seek to exploit the vulnerable for their twisted pleasure. Hostel was written and directed by Eli Roth and produced by Quentin Tarantino. It received critical acclaim for its brutal realism and exploration of dark themes, but also sparked controversy for its graphic violence. With its unflinching exploration of the darkest corners of the human psyche, Hostel stands as an example of the power of cinema to confront our fears and ignite critical reflection on the shadows that dance at the edge of our civilized world. Hostel is a horror movie that is 1 hour and 34 minutes long and is rated R. The Southern Underworld gives it 3.5 bloody knives. And now for the second in the series, Hostel 2. Beneath the sun-drenched facade of Rome, Beth, Whitney, and Lorna, three American art students, seek artistic inspiration in the Eternal City. Drawn by alluring whispers of a secluded Slovakian spa offering rejuvenation and relaxation, they stumble upon a horrifying truth far more twisted than any Renaissance masterpiece. Director Eli Roth returns to the bleak world established in Hostel, but this time, he expands the scope of his exploration of the dark tourism industry, weaving a disturbing tapestry of human trafficking, sadistic entertainment, and the insidious normalization of violence. The familiar backdrop of the Slovakian hostel takes on a new dimension, its claustrophobic corridors and dimly lit chambers now buzzing with a grotesque sense of carnivalesque horror. The performances are raw and gritty, reflecting the characters' descent into despair and their desperate struggle for survival. Lauren German as Beth delivers an outstanding portrayal of resilience and defiance, while Bijou Phillips and Heather Matarazzo capture the chilling transformation of carefree tourists into traumatized prey. Hostel 2 deviates from the straightforward slasher narrative of its predecessor, choosing instead to delve into the psychological underpinnings of its characters and the motivations of their tormentors. It explores the commodification of violence, where the extinguishing of human lives becomes mere entertainment for wealthy thrill seekers. Hostel 2 is more than just a horror sequel. It's a brutal and unflinching indictment of the darkest corners of human nature. Roth pushes the boundaries of cinematic depiction of violence, but does so with a purpose that goes beyond mere shock value. He forces the audience to confront the unsettling reality of a world where human suffering is a spectator sport for the privileged few. The film's horror is not solely visceral, but also deeply psychological, playing on our primal fears of isolation, betrayal, and the chilling realization that we can become mere objects in someone else's depraved game. Hostel 2's graphic violence, disturbing subject matter, and exploration of human cruelty can be deeply unsettling for some viewers. However, for those who appreciate a good slasher film, Hostel 2 is a powerful experience and a great addition to the series. The film's strength lies in its ability to challenge our perceptions of the lengths to which humans are capable of descending in the pursuit of gratification. It reminds us that the monsters we most fear are not always lurking in the shadows, but can sometimes dwell within the hearts of those who seek to exploit the vulnerable for their twisted enjoyment. With its brutal realism and chilling examination of the depths of human depravity, Hostel 2 confronts our darkest fears and delves into shadows that dance at the edge of our civilized world. Hostel 2 is a horror movie that is 1 hour and 34 minutes long and is rated R. The Southern Underworld gives us 3.5 bloody knives. And now the last in the series, Hostel 3. In Hostel Part 3, the sinister underground organization continues its depraved operation, offering wealthy clients the ultimate thrill of sadistic torture. Set in Las Vegas, the film follows a group of bachelor party attendees who find themselves ensnared in the deadly game. As the festivities kick off, the group indulges in the hedonistic pleasures of Sin City, unaware of the danger lurking beneath the surface. When they encounter a charismatic stranger who promises them access to an exclusive, off-the-grid experience, they eagerly accept, craving an adrenaline rush beyond their wildest dreams. However, their excitement quickly turns to horror as they realize they've been lured into a trap orchestrated by the sadistic elite hunting club. Stripped of their autonomy, they become pawns in a deadly game of cat and mouse, where survival is measured by the capacity to endure unimaginable pain. As the nightmarish ordeal unfolds, alliances are forged and betrayals abound, as the group struggles to outwit their captors and escape the clutches of the bloodthirsty hunters. With each passing moment, the line between predator and prey blurs, leaving the characters questioning their humanity in the face of unspeakable cruelty. In a heart-pounding race against time, the survivors must navigate a labyrinth of torture chambers and twisted games, where death lurks around every corner. With the odds stacked against them, they must summon every ounce of courage and cunning to evade their fate and emerge from the hellish nightmare alive. Hostel, Part 3, serves as a chilling reminder of the depths of human depravity and the fragility of life in a world where morality holds no sway and the pursuit of pleasure knows no bounds. Hostel, Part 3, plunges audiences into a nightmarish descent into the bowels of human depravity, delivering a relentless onslaught of terror that will leave even the most hardened horror aficionados trembling in their seats. Director Scott Spiegel expertly ratchets up the tension from the opening moments, setting a foreboding tone that permeates every frame of the film. From the glitzy neon lights of Las Vegas to the dimly lit corridors of the elite hunting club's lair, the atmosphere drips with an unsettling sense of dread, leaving viewers on the edge of their seats. Where Hostel Part 3 truly excels is in its unflinching portrayal of violence and torture. Spiegel pulls no punches, delivering a series of gruesome set pieces that will disturb even the most hardened horror fans. From bone-chilling screams to visceral gore, the film pulls viewers into the heart of darkness, confronting them with the brutal reality of human cruelty. But beyond the blood and gore lies a deeper message about the nature of evil and the corruption of power. The elite hunting club serves as a metaphor for the darkest corners of human nature, where morality is sacrificed on the altar of pleasure and pain. In this world, the line between predator and prey blurs, leaving the characters grappling with their capacity for violence and depravity. In the end, Hostel Part 3 is a harrowing journey and relentless roller coaster of terror that will leave audiences gasping for breath. With its chilling atmosphere, visceral violence, and thought-provoking themes, the film cements its place as a modern horror classic, destined to haunt viewers long after the credits roll. Enter if you dare, but beware. Once you step into the world of Hostel Part 3, there's no turning back. I liked this installment of the series the most of the three, but the violence and gore got to be a bit much for me. Hostel 3 is a horror movie that is 1 hour and 28 minutes and is rated R. The Southern Underworld gives it 4 bloody knives. these films tap into our primal fears of the unknown and the dangers lurking in seemingly ordinary situations. One of the things that make the Hostel series so intriguing is how they explore the dark side of human nature and the depths to which people can sink when driven by their most basic desires. At the surface, the Hostel movies are often dismissed as mere torture flicks, but there's more to them than meets the eye. They offer commentary on various themes such as hedonism, capitalism, and globalization. The idea of a secret organization catering to the wealthy elite's twisted desires by providing them with victims for torture and murder is chillingly plausible in a world where power and privilege often seem to reign supreme. Moreover, these films also raise questions about the nature of tourism and the voyeuristic tendencies of society. By portraying backpackers as unsuspecting victims who fall prey to the horrors of the Hostel, the movies force us to confront our fascination with violence and our tendency to objectify others, especially those from different cultures or backgrounds. But perhaps what's most disturbing about the Hostel series is its exploration of the banality of evil. The villains in these films are not cartoonish monsters, but rather ordinary-looking people who could easily blend into society. This serves as a reminder that evil often wears a mundane face, lurking just beneath the surface of everyday life. Cabin Fever was my first exposure to Eli Roth, and I am a huge fan of the horror genre, obviously, and his work in particular. This being said, the amount and intensity of the violence in these movies did bother me, but if you look at this series, gore and shock value aside, they provide a chilling glimpse into the darkest corners of the human psyche and leave us questioning our morality and capacity for empathy. If you can handle the gore and are a fan of slasher horror films, these films are worth a look. Don't forget to hit that thumbs up below, subscribe to the channel, and share this video to help our little channel grow. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe to the channel. See you next time. Thank you for watching.